the paintings have a little moon or a little planet. The planet is a symbol for me to remember that we are only a small planet in a large, huge universe. So that little moon on the painting represents the feeling of don't forget that you are there this moment, and it's something much bigger out there, and you can only do the best because you cannot control. The art is always an expression which is closer to the everyday life than the formal idea of what is real. There is an old truth in every new creation. The material world is anchored in our history. We have learned to create our own life, and we realize that every moment we're recreating ourselves, because the result is the choices we make. And when we in the moment see the other person in front of us and see each other, we definitely reach further. My motifs are very classic. I like still lifes because it brings me back to the history of painting. I'm trying to, like a chain of painters, to work with a material that has over the hundreds of years been developed. I work with glass, painting and neon. My paintings are painted on glass. The light is neon tubes. I start my work with, I find frames. I'm looking for antique frames because I find the frame being a little bit a symbol of myself and life itself. We all carry our own frames in that way. We all are own individuals, and we learn from our mistakes and we learn from our history and we frame ourselves. It's up to me as a person to choose who I want to be and to develop that and do the best I can be, because nobody else can help you except yourself. The frames comes mostly from a dealer in New York. Starting with the frame, I find frames from mostly turn of the century, between 1800 and 1900. I don't see the framing as a painting with a frame. I see the frame and the painting as an object. It's all connected. It's all one thing. They belong together. And these still lifes are based on the frame some way, but it's also ideas that I'm picking up from history of painting, and I'm trying to develop my own take on history. The still lifes also represent an image that we all know and we all can feel familiar with. Any culture will understand a fruit or a still life. And these are lit up, reminding us of the inner light, the light that we all carry, that keeps us living and working. My studio is in Brooklyn at something called Brooklyn Glass. There I do my castings and my neon. But otherwise I travel, I spend a lot of time in Mexico, I've been in Japan. I can travel and paint, because since I have the frame first, I have the measurement of the work, I have the frame, and wherever I go, I can buy a piece of plate glass and I can paint there. Again, that's a little part of my philosophy, that the Impressionist came about because the tin tube and the synthetic paints were discovered. Being able to bring your paint with you out in the nature, you could start painting in plain air and the colors got much stronger. Science is always hand in hand with the art field. So that's my take on that, with using the neon, which is hand in hand with our times. My idea that the frame belongs to the painting, it has to be in the same manner. And that's the start, that's my inspiration. I can start with the frame and I can look at the frame and I see with my inner vision or my inner mind that this is what I would like to do with this frame. And then I can repaint it sometimes, or I can put another liner, or I do a little variation to this to make it more fitting, to make it look like this is the frame and the painting. It is one package.